So, I've been doing YouTube for a few years now, and a lot of my recent videos have been doing great. Thanks for that. My most popular video, though, is still this one from last January. It's interesting to watch it and see how much things have changed since then. For example, the description still links to my now delisted mobile game on Google Play, and my Game Jolt page, which I don't use anymore. I would be worried about this link rot costing me sales or views, but, well, I don't think it'll be a problem for the time being. However, my motto has always been, fake it till you make it, so I try to think ahead to when things like this actually do matter. When I lose dozens or hundreds of sales because my description links to an old game instead of the new hotness. I wish there was some sort of hub system that would redirect people to my latest projects. Of course, if you're only interested in YouTube, the subscribe button is probably your best bet for that, but most of my work is outside of this platform. The same goes for Twitter and Steam. Linking to my itch.io page has worked in the past, but that excludes my non-game projects. Linking to my GitHub has the opposite problem. These days, most people use something like Linktree, but that's bare bones and prone to the whims of some other company. I need something permanent. Something, well, you saw the title. I need a website. Of course, beyond just being a link dump, a website is useful for a lot of other reasons. It lets you practice your web development skills, which are sorely lacking for me. It usually comes with a free email address, and people tend to find it pretty impressive. In the world of things that cost $40 a year, it's up there with too many streaming services and half a Discord Nitro. Alright, so how do you go about buying a website? Well, for me it was simple. I went on GoDaddy, which happened to be having a promotion, won domain name and email address for 40 bucks, and looked up Mondobi.com. Choosing the name was a fairly simple process for me since I've been using the Mondobi username pretty much everywhere on the internet, and even in real life for a while now, but for others you may have a more difficult time. These days though I don't think it matters as much since most people access websites through links rather than typing the URLs. Really, actually buying the domain is optional. I could have easily used a github.io link instead. I also wanted the email address though, so I sprang for the package deal. Unfortunately, a name does not come with a free server. I can't just register the trademark Fortnite 2 GTA 7 Edition and receive a free copy of the greatest game ever made, and I can't just buy Mondobi.com and conjure up some free hosting space. Also, I only had a budget of $40 for this project, so I was out of money. So I had to be crafty. Luckily, Google's Firebase service offers a limited free plan for web hosting, so I took that opportunity. Now that I've got the ingredients for web hosting, I just need to mix them all up. Of course, GoDaddy doesn't know that I activated a Firebase plan, and Firebase doesn't know that I bought a domain name. So how do I get them to communicate? Well, it involves a series of something called DNS records. Basically, from my knowledge, when your computer is told to visit a website, it first consults this big server called a name server. GoDaddy uploads some records to this name server that tells it, hey, if a computer asks for Mondobi.com, send them to this IP address. I want this IP address to lead to that server that Firebase has so generously donated to me, so I set that up in GoDaddy's control panel. I also set up the Firebase console commands, which allow me to write HTML files on my computer and upload them to Google's servers. Pretty soon, I had the domain name connected to the server, and we were ready to code. And when I say code, I actually mean procrastinate for several days. I mean, you'd do the same thing if you literally had a website, wouldn't you? So for the first few days, I just had this picture of Tom York's face. Eventually, though, I got down to business. When coding a website, there are the obvious questions of what JavaScript framework to use, what CSS extension, what state management, etc., etc. I wanted to make something small, simple, and client-side, so I settled on vanilla HTML, CSS, and JavaScript written from scratch with as little JavaScript as possible. I started with the homepage, where I put a big breezy banner on screen. I added a few sections talking about my various activities, mainly game dev, YouTube, and other programming stuff, and of course, I crammed the whole thing full of links. But that was just the beginning. Oh no, there's plenty more to do. I created a sticky navigation bar at the top of the website with tabs for About Me, Games, Projects, and Links. I added some menus under the navigation bar with a litany of other links. I covered the whole thing with my signature bodily waste hues, and I painted it all with what I think is a pleasant, thick-lined aesthetic. Finally, I used a small script to automatically add that header and a footer to every page in the website. So, I hear what you're thinking. What did you do with the website? Surely it's not all just blank pages filled with external links. Of course, I took time to add plenty of exclusive Mondobi brand content. I was inspired by Eric S. Raymond, an internet pioneer I mentioned in a video a few months ago. Remember when I said that basically every modern browser exists thanks to his work? Well, his website is also really neat, with tons of nooks and crannies. It's like a mini Zelda game of stumbling across random links that you apparently haven't clicked yet, although it probably helps that everything this man does is pretty wild. and that he's been documenting it all for over 20 years. I doubt my website will get to this level, but I want to do something similar with a dense labyrinth of information scattered throughout. It's something that you can't really do with a linear social media feed, and unless you have a bunch of accounts or something. For example, I've got this history section detailing how I started programming and developing games. From there, you can access a blog post I made in elementary school, as well as a transcription since some of the formatting is broken. I want to keep expanding the website and adding things like that, and it'll be easier as I just do more things. And of course, I've accomplished my original mission of creating a hub for all my links. I've tried to make the most useful ones really accessible, like the link to Breezy or my itch page, and you may have noticed that I'm linking to the website in places where others put their Linktree, Twitter, YouTube, etc., even in the description of this very video. So, that's how I made my website. Give it a whirl if you want. I didn't delve too deep into the specifics of the coding, and I don't have a public GitHub repo for it because, well, if we're being honest, I am not the person you want to learn web development from. It was certainly a fun experience, though, which leaves one question. Should you make a website? Well, if you know how to code or are a quick learner, I certainly recommend trying it out. Just make a quick homepage to host on GitHub, or if you're willing to splurge, buy a domain name like I did. It's certainly more fulfilling than coming up with a Twitter bio. I mentioned it earlier, but thanks for the traction on my last few videos. I already axed the plan I mentioned for unscripted content, but I do want to try having a more consistent upload schedule by planning out my videos more. It's also the start of the semester, so I have some free time. As you're watching this, I should be finished, or almost finished, with my entry for the first round of the Game Dev Knockout Jam. I should throw a link somewhere, or else release a trailer alongside this video. Or both. At any rate, have a good day.